Hello, and today we are with Miss Christina Cheng, who is the General Manager of the Harbour Plaza 8 Degrees here in Hong Kong. Good afternoon to you, Miss Cheng.
Hi, good afternoon.
Miss Cheng, Harbour Plaza, you have seven Harbour Plaza hotels
yes.
here in Hong Kong. There's one in China. There's two Rambler hotels
exactly.
also in Hong Kong. But this brand here, this 8 Degrees, it's a new brand. How does it differ and how does it fit into the Harbour Plaza portfolio?
Actually, Harbour Plaza, our group, we have three brands. One is the Harbour Grand. Basically, we have two Harbour Grand in Hong Kong. And then we have two Rambler. The others are all Harbour Plaza. So Harbour Plaza in this company is more like a four-star hotel, four and a half-star hotel brand. And basically, when the owner planned on this hotel, I think one of the reasons is because we have so many Harbour Plaza hotels in Hong Kong. So we try to create a name that can avoid confusion. And also because I heard that with the previous airport, the Kai Tak Airport, when the airplane take off, it's about 8 degrees. That's one of the reasons that our owner was very smart and then say, let's name this hotel to be Harbour Plaza 8 degrees. And after the name was developed, the designer kind of like put this degree, 8 degree element into the hotel design. So the minute you walk into the hotel, you know, you can feel this very obvious illusion slided, but actually indeed the whole lobby is really flat. It's a design, you know, near the front office on the wall that makes you feel this kind of like very special, memorable feeling. And also with the chandelier on the rooftop, you can also feel it's slightly 8 degrees.
Now, I have to admit, when I first walked into the lobby, you know what travellers are like. We tend to rush in, we don't look at anything, we get to the lobby, reception, and check in, go up to the room. But when I stopped to look at
yes.
that illusion,
yes.
it's very impressive.
Extremely, I must say. We have so many guests, you know, they try to nail down, you know, put a ball on the floor, and then when they approach the front office counter, they put a pen. And thinking that it's going to roll down, but actually indeed not. Everything is so flat, you know.
Who was the designer behind that?
It's a special designer contracted by our company. His main, actually, as I say, work focus actually right now is in China. It's a very famous local designer.
Oh, very good. Hmm. Now, you have, this isn't, I wasn't going to use the word boutique, and we can't use the word boutique because
yeah.
you have 702
rooms
and
yes.
suites. How do the rooms, you basically target two different clientele. You have long stay and short stay.
Yes.
How many rooms are targeted at both of those at the moment?
For long stay, it's about 100 rooms. And then we play it quite flexible. For some month, maybe up to 130. And then for some month, you know, when the hotel business is so busy, we might down to 80 rooms. The good thing about this company, most of our sister hotel, we have a combination of service suite and hotel rooms so that we can maximize the yield and the potential for the hotel. It depends on the high-low season.
Right. And how do the rooms here at 8 degrees, how do the rooms differ in terms of the long and short stays?
For the long staying room, normally we have a kitchenette. So it's very convenient. So basically range from 350 square feet to over 500 square feet, one bedroom suite. With the kitchenette, so far, I think this hotel, when we first opened in 2009, has become very popular. We have a lot of like this 1 to 2 month stay. People looking for a new house during renovation. We even have some people coming here to have, you know, this pregnant market, you know, from China, I feel. So up to now, I think it's getting very popular in Hong Kong. When people are looking for service suite, we call it service suite in the hotel. It's been doing very well.
Right. So the remainder for the short stays, for the one nights, two
yes.
nights, three
yes.
nights stays, there you have 600 odd rooms
yes.
Still available.
Yes.
How have you cut up the room categories of those 600 rooms?
Basically, this hotel, we have two views. One is called a street view. The other is patio. Patio is overlooking a very nice garden, a beautiful swimming pool. So basically, it's we call it patio room and also the street level. And also depends on the size. We have basic superior and then deluxe, larger rooms, and then suite.
Right.
We also have three club floor, especially for the business travelers, for the executive traveling to Hong Kong, looking for a bit more service, like this very nice cup lunch. We serve breakfast, tea, snacks, cocktails.
Right. Mm. And is there a large price difference, or do you have a promotion where, for example, if somebody is in a regular room, they can upgrade themselves at a reasonable price?
Very reasonable. It's about 350 to 400, depends on the season.
Right.
So it's become more and more popular right now, yeah.
Now, obviously, within the region, you're very well known, Harbour Plaza. Are there any, but internationally, are there any common concepts between the 8 Degrees, the other Harbour Plaza that you have? Are they all the same star category, or are there differences there? And are there any concepts which run throughout the brand and the group?
Harbour Plaza, I think, is like what I mentioned just now, we have basically is 4 to 5 star hotels. So 5 star are the Harbour Grand, 4 star are all the other Harbour Plaza. Good thing about our company is that almost 10 years now, we have established over 13 overseas sales offices worldwide. And when we opened this hotel, we have a lot of help from those offices, from China to Japan to Korea to Australia, UK, USA. And past 2 or 3 years, we started India, Russia. So it also helps a lot when we've opened this hotel. If you, like in the morning, it's special breakfast time, you can see a very good international mix. You won't just see one market here. Especially the long-haul market is really improving. USA, UK, Australia, Germany, you know, it's a very good, well-balanced mix.
Right. Now, in terms of service as well, a lot of hotel companies, I'll mention a few, Shangri-La, Best Western, Carlson, Wyndham, they all now are offering complimentary internet across all their room categories for all of their guests, regardless of room rate. What is the Plaza A at the 8 Degrees Hotel here, and what is the policy across the Harbour Plaza Group?
For the Harbour Plaza Hotel Group, we work with one of our subsidiary companies. So for the internet service, we do charge guests. But compared to many of our competitors, our basic room rate are actually very competitive. So when you put up the additional charge for internet, actually still is a very, very attractive rate.
Is this something that you will be planning on changing? Because a lot more and more hotels now are choosing to include it within the rate.
Yes, we are working on that, yes.
Mm-hmm. Is there any timeline?
I think we're looking at like the next 12 to 24 months. Depends on how we can negotiate with our supplier and how we are going to repackage maybe the room rate. Or we can start like what you have mentioned from deluxe category room of work. Because for the leisure travelers, the need is not so much. And for this hotel, especially 8 Degrees at this location, at this moment, it's still, I think, 70% of leisure, about 30% of business travelers.
Right. Now, this hotel, the 8 Degrees, it's a little bit step into the contemporary, the more trendy, the funky side of the hotel industry than Harbour Plaza is traditionally known for. How far are you willing to take technology, things like self-check-in facilities that hotels are doing? How far is the 8 Degrees brand going to push the envelope?
At this moment, I think it's because the hotel is still quite new, we still tend to put in a lot of like personal services, like doing guest check-in, check-out, and whatever this planning in the future may be, it's going to be the group, you know, involved. It won't be happen just for one particular Harbour Plaza. So I understand our corporate office is reviewing a lot of this high-tech issue, trying to set up a plan, but that's going to embrace all the Harbour Plaza hotels, not only for a particular one.
Right. And another new trend is 24-hour stays. What are your thoughts on such such an offering?
I'm a bit for this question, you know, confused about what you exactly want to know about 24-hour stay.
For example, where somebody can check in at 6 in the morning and they can keep their room until 6 in the morning or 6 in the p.m. to 6 p.m. in basically a 24-hour period rather than the traditional you must check in at after 2, you must check out before 12, for example.
We tend to be very flexible for our guests due for the check-in, check-out special requests, but because of the very high occupancy average in Hong Kong, I think most hotels are above 80%, so to run into this practice is still a bit difficult. Still a lot of guests that when they check in, they request, you know, they know that they have to come during, you know, noontime. If this 24-hour check-in, I think at this moment it's a bit difficult to execute due to the very high demand and very high occupancy level in Hong Kong.
Right. Yeah. A lot of travellers nowadays, you yourself are proof of this, women are becoming more and more common in the workplace, in senior positions. They're travelling a lot more frequently. A lot of hotels have also started doing female-only floors, improved security, more amenities that are aimed directly at the female traveller. Is this what are your thoughts on this sort of service, and is this something that you think Harbour Plaza and 8 Degrees specifically will be offering?
This is a very good idea, I must say. You know, we have been seeing more and more lady traveler from business, but because this hotel right now our focus is still on the leisure side, but definitely this is going to be a plan that we will be looking at in the future. Maybe special amenities in the room, maybe a little bit, a small pot of greens in the room, you know, it's more feminine feel, but definitely this is something that we will be looking at in the future.
Right.
Yes.
Now, obviously location, everybody's location, location. And a lot of people might not know this area. I've flown, I'm sure you have, we've both flown into the old airport, but a lot of people won't know this area. Could you tell us, what exactly is this area all about? What does it have to offer travellers, and how, if somebody was normally staying over in Central or in the heart of Sim Sha Tsui, what would you say to them to bring them over to this hotel?
This is a very good area that people are looking at, exploring a bit more like old Hong Kong. A lot of interesting old buildings around this area. And also it's easy to travelers to recognize, as we always mention, it's very close to the old airport, Kai Tak Airport, because the Kai Tak Airport has been, I think, very known in the market internationally for many, many years. And also this area provides a lot of really very closely small local restaurants. And not only just local, but also like Japanese, small Korean restaurants. It's all within walking distance. And one very special about this area is the people, the neighborhood around are very friendly people. They're very down to the earth. If you walk outside, you know, hello, good morning. The feeling is really good. That's why in the beginning, we do have some difficulty in marketing this area. But what we have seen is that on a daily basis, the repeat guest ratio is extremely high. We have guests, now the hotel is less than 2 years. It's like stay here for over 80 times already. Every day on what we call the repeat guest list is really increasing. And the good thing is because we concern a lot on the guest comments, so we go to the different websites, we push for comment card, but I must say, I think over 90% the comments are very good. Maybe the location is still a little bit new compared to downtown, but it's the people, the service that makes a lot of difference. And after all, I think Hong Kong is a very small city, you know. It's unlike, you know, in Japan, in Tokyo, or in UK. Even from here to downtown Sim Sha Tsui, you're talking about 15 minutes. It's just so convenient. And also we provide complimentary shuttle bus.
I wanted to ask you about that.
A very beautiful green bus.
It is a very beautiful green bus,
attractive.
I must admit. But I wanted to ask you about that because a lot of hotels have challenge when it comes to the minibus, but they don't have 702 rooms. You have a lot of rooms. How do you, first of all, how frequent is the minibus service that you offer? And how do you manage the demand? Because with 702 rooms, there has to be a lot of demand.
Basically, it's a complimentary service. So to be very honest, it's first come, first serve. The frequency is about 15 to 20 minutes because basically we have two routes, A and B. One is for express because most of the travelers, they want to go to Sim Sha Tsui, you know, and that we want more frequent. The other one goes to the train station and then to the airport express. So basically this is very convenient. So far, I think we have not encountered really major issue. And plus the fact that even if the guests cannot catch the shuttle bus, I think about $30 Hong Kong, you are in Sim Sha Tsui already. So compared to taxi fare in Hong Kong, internationally, Hong Kong taxi is very, very inexpensive.
Right. Yeah. Now, obviously, if people are finding what you're saying very interesting, they want to come and stay at this hotel. Where is the best place to book? Do you have a best available rate guarantee?
Yes. We have a best available rate on our own website. We also work with many online travel portals. So basically, we have been trying our very best, and actually, I think almost 100% is all rate parity. So basically, unless you buy special airline packages, you might find a rate difference. but the rate on the website is indeed the best available rate, yes.
And do you offer a guarantee? So for example, if somebody does find cheaper online, do you offer a guarantee?
No, at this moment we cannot offer a guarantee because, you know, the web world is so extensive, so big, you know. Sometimes, you know, somebody may, a third party in from some channel, they may have put up a rate that we don't even know, you know. So I think it's kind of like difficult to guarantee. But compared to other online travel portal, we can guarantee the rate is the best.
Right.
It's all rate parity.
Right. Frequent travelers, they're always worried about miles and points.
Yes.
In regards to the group, at the moment, Harbour Plaza, you just have the corporate incentive program, I believe.
Yes.
Is there a plan to actually do something for the leisure traveler on a group basis? And also for this hotel individually, are people able to earn points through their own frequent flyer?
Yes, we work membership with Asia Mile for the whole group for a number of years already. This has become very popular, Asia Mile, and then since 2-3 years ago, we also start with China Air, Jack Air. So we do provide such kind of mileage program. Plus, you know, each Harbour Plaza have their own in-house loyalty program for repeat guests, upgrade, maybe free breakfast for your next visit, some souvenirs, gift items. It has been running quite popular. But for the group basis at this moment, I think Asia Mile is the only program that embraces the whole group.
Right. But obviously, Harbour Plaza, you are expanding. You do have expansion plans further afield. Is there no plans to actually do a group like a Harbour Plaza, like Shanghai, like the other hotel companies? They have their own internal.
Yes. We have been discussing this for a few times, but the issue is that I think all our hotels in Hong Kong, so compared to the major hotel chain, it's a bit difficult. Unless you have a hotel in all the major cities that you can link up the business travelers, you know, when you go to Tokyo, Taipei, Seoul, you can stay at the same brand hotel. But all our hotels are in Hong Kong, so it's kind of like difficult. Like for a guest who stay at the Harbour Grand, he may not come and stay at the 8 Degree. For a guest who stay at 8 Degree, may not go to Hong Kong Island and stay at North Point. So we tend to have our own quite distinctive client base, which is difficult to group them together for international loyalty program.
Right.
That's why each of us, we do have our own program.
Right, which obviously brings me to the question with regards to 8 degrees,
yeah.
How long will it be until we have another 8 degrees?
I think I don't know at this moment, but I know our owner, they have a passion in hotel business. I think if there's suitable opportunities or a piece of land, you know, which is with good value, they might continue to invest in hotel business. But at this moment, for Harbour Plaza, I have no news for additional property. No.
Right. Which for this hotel here, what's your top 2 or 3 markets that actually are staying at the hotel at the moment?
Actually, at this moment, we have the long haul, short haul. For the short haul, it's basically China, Japan, Korea, Taiwan, and Singapore. For long haul market, basically is Australia, USA, UK, and Germany. Definitely, the China market, the percentage will be higher because basically the statistics shows 66% of people coming to Hong Kong stay overnight are from China. So I think all hotels tend to have a higher base of the Chinese market base. But good thing is what we have seen for 8 degrees, that compared to the opening, our FIT has been improved drastically compared to when we first opened, that we have a huge group base. This is something that what we want to see also. Especially we see actually a decrease in the group number of room nights in terms of percentage, but FIT has been really growing very healthily.
And which markets are you primarily targeting for this increase in FITs?
FITs basically is on the business travelers, it's the OTA, is our own website also.
Right, and any particular markets, or are you looking to maintain the same ratios like you mentioned earlier?
No. I think we still see ways to further improve our market mix. I would like to further improve on the long haul market side to bring in more international travelers, not to squeeze out the short-haul market. But overall, I would also like to increase the occupancy level. For the first year, it's about 80-something. I think for this year, next year going into, I hope to reach like 88-90%. That means I need more support from all over internationally.
Sounds very good. And will the average room rates increase at the same amount?
Oh yes. For the first 4 months this year, our rate compared to last year, same period, close to 30% increase in average rate.
Which is to say how much?
More than $100, yes.
Increase.
Yes, increase. Excellent. So I think we're doing quite well, yeah. Because I mean, to be honest, for a new hotel, I think the rate increment for the first 2-3 years, the potential will be more significant.
Yeah. Excellent. Well, it sounds like you are doing very, very well indeed, Ms. Cheng. And I have to thank you very much for your time today.
Oh, thank you so much. Yes.
I wish you the best of luck here at the hotel, and good luck with the future.
Well, we look forward to welcoming you back next time.
Thank you. Thank you,
Ms. Cheng. So much.